Good afternoon, everyone. Can you hear me okay? Everyone in the back? All right, awesome. Well, I hope everyone enjoyed lunch. Now that our stomachs are full, we can dive into how to harness your own story. So my name is Angelica Katz, and I am the Northeast Regional Manager for Susan G. Komen. I cover state policy and advocacy. And before I begin, I just want to tell you a little bit about myself and what I do, and more importantly, why I do it. So in my position, I do a lot of talking, mostly to legislators. I provide them statistics, I provide them data, studies. I basically just make them care about the issue and why it's important to us. But more importantly, I stay silent a lot. And that's because a lot of the times I'm accompanied in legislator meetings with folks like yourself who share their own personal stories. And they are the ones that explain the why. They're the ones that do the talking. They're the ones that make legislators understand the issue. They're the ones that make it relatable. And most importantly, they put a face to and a voice to the issue that we're advocating for. It makes the issue real. So let me give you an example. We had a person just like yourself, an advocate. We have an advocate. Her name is Keisha, and she is living with metastatic breast cancer. Keisha was a bus driver. She had to quit her job because of the treatment she was on. And she, because of that, she lost her insurance. And when she had to go on state insurance, she was required to go through a new step therapy protocol. And for some of you who might not be familiar with step therapy, this is referred to often as fail first. It requires a patient to first try a health plan preferred drug, have that drug fail the patient, meaning the drug just didn't work, before they can use the same treatment that their provider had prescribed. This is often a health plan tool used as an attempt to control cost. And despite growing evidence showing that this is negatively impacting patients, it's still something that patients have to jump through. And because of Keisha and others like her, we were able to successfully ban this step therapy practice in the state she was from. We couldn't have done it without her. She put a face and a voice to the issue, and if it wasn't for her, step therapy protocols would have still been in place in her state. So that's a little bit about why I do the work that I do, because I'm inspired every day by folks like yourself, who are really the ones who are on the ground changing hearts and minds of legislators, not just for themselves, but for those who will come after them. So that brings me here today. I'm going to teach you how to harness your own story and how to make an impact like Keisha. So I'm going to go over what advocacy is, how does Susan G. Komen impact change, the power of your own story. We're going to have a little breakout session before we close. And before I begin, I just want to have everybody keep this in mind during the presentation. This is a quote I really like by Alice Walker, author of The Color Purple. And she says, "Activism is my rent for living on the planet." So just keep that in mind during the presentation. So what is advocacy? Advocacy is how we use our knowledge to put pressure on the people and the institutions that have the power to give you what you want. It's working towards change for the betterment, for yourself, for your neighbors, your family, your friends. It's informing decision makers about the benefits of policy change, or sometimes why that policy change might be harmful. It's building a persuasive case for a particular change, and it's engaging the whole community and organizing to advance good, sound public policy. And here at Komen Center for Public Policy, our mission is to empower people and policymakers with using knowledge. It's to connect our advocates together, and it's to mobilize everyone to act to create lasting change. We know that more than 42,000 people in the US, unfortunately, will die every year from breast cancer. And while we know metastatic breast cancer cannot be cured, multiple treatments for the disease now exist, and we are only getting more advanced. By mobilizing our communities to take action, we can ensure that the voice and needs of the breast cancer community, specifically the MBC community, are represented in Congress, are represented on the state level, and they are heard by policymakers and government officials. So, how do we do this? What are some ways that we advocate? As mentioned, we educate state and federal policymakers. We sometimes help draft legislation. We provide feedback on some regulations. We activate our base. We turn patients into advocates. We empower and we mobilize our communities. And we join state and federal coalitions. We also use social media and all news outlets to get our message across and make sure our voices are heard. And again, I can't repeat it enough, we educate the public. And here's an example of some of our Komen advocates where we had lobbied state capitals. On the far right is where when we were in Pennsylvania. So this is all over the country. We do this work not just in the state, but we do it everywhere. So now that I discussed a little bit about what advocacy is and where we advocate, I want to focus on you and your story. So the power of your story and how you can impact change. Again, I can't say it enough. Real patient stories are what make real changes. Your story is a critical tool to making the case for policy changes. When a person lends their voice, it makes a huge difference, and sharing a story is not the same as sharing statistics and data. It's what makes it real. I can say to legislators, every 12 minutes, one woman will lose her life from breast cancer. I can say African-American women in the US will die from breast cancer, about 40% more than their white counterparts. I can say that breast cancer is the leading cause of death for all Hispanic women in the US. But again, unless lawmakers hear from you, my statistics aren't gonna hold any weight. So where can your story make a difference in advocacy? So in this pyramid, you can see the legislative process in Pennsylvania. And everything bolded is where you can directly make an impact on the legislative process. As I said, legislators who make important decisions, they receive much of that information from you, from their constituents. I've been a legislative staffer, and I can tell you during my meetings with advocates and constituents, those are the meetings that I paid attention to. Those are the ones that I brought back to my member, and I said, look, we need to take action. So in this process, you can see from beginning to end, the bill idea. That comes from you. That's where you can make an impact. Then the bill is introduced to a committee, and it's referred. And then when the committee considers that bill, that's where you can also make an impact. That's where you can say, I support this bill. Or you can say, I don't support this bill. It's going to harm me. When the committee votes, you can also speak with your legislator. You can send emails. You can call their office. You can voice your opinion. Once the bill goes to the House floor or the Senate floor and there's a debate, again, that's where we would need you. As a Komen advocate, you can submit testimony. You can sign up to work with our grassroots team and just, you know, make sure that your voice is heard by your legislator. And even all the way to the last step until the bill is enacted, even when the bill is before the governor's desk, you can still make an impact. So pretty much through this entire process, your story is what legislators need to hear, and that's where the real change comes from. So now that you know that your story is important, I hope we all got that much right now. So now that you know it's important, how do you actually build your story? So again, this is your own personal experience. You know, sometimes folks think like, where do I begin? Which part of the journey do I take from? And I'll say there is no right or wrong answer here. Sometimes the piece of your journey that you share really depends on the piece of legislation that we're, you know, that we're trying to introduce or the goal that we're trying to accomplish. And while I can't tell you what part of your story to share, what I can tell you is a lot of the times what our advocates' stories all have in common is what we like to call a hook, line, and a sinker. So the hook, it draws the audience in. The line is what you provide that gives the member your personal story or your personal connection to the issue. And then the sinker is the ask. So just to recap, again, the hook is what draws the audience in. For example, it can be a statistic like 1 in 8 women will be diagnosed with breast cancer. The line, your personal connection. This can describe a challenge or a roadblock that you might have faced. It can be something like, you know, if I didn't have access to life-saving diagnostic or treatment, you wouldn't have received the necessary diagnosis to help keep you alive today. And then the sinker, which is the ask, it's just simply, you know, what do you need? For example, I want everyone to have access to affordable diagnostic testing at no cost to the patient. All right. And now here's a patient story, and you will hear from Katie.
My name is Katie Strobel, and being an advocate means that my daughters get to see how I have taken this cancer diagnosis and made good out of it. I was first diagnosed with breast cancer in November of 2022. I had been breastfeeding my son, and I noticed I had a lump in my right breast. A barrier that I have experienced with my care is I had a very hard time getting an ultrasound of my breast or a mammogram in the very beginning because I was only 28 years old. I was healthy. I had no cancer in my family history. I did not receive my first mammogram until I was diagnosed with cancer because my insurance wouldn't pay for the mammogram because I was so young. Lawmakers can help us bring an end to breast cancer by giving women with breast cancer better access to the things they need, whether that's access to healthcare, disability, treatment. There are a ton of other burdens that women and men with breast cancer go through when they're trying to receive treatment. I know for me, it was finding childcare and being able to afford that childcare when it wasn't a family member. Giving these women access to healthcare, health insurance, disability, ways for them to take off all of these other burdens. There are so many other factors besides just the treatment that go into fighting breast cancer. And I think if lawmakers gave women and men a fighting chance to be able to take those burdens out of the treatment, they would be able to recover a lot sooner, to get this treatment a lot sooner, and to be able to go to these doctor's appointments to get the diagnosis to begin with. I make sure that my story is out there so that women know they are not alone, that they know that they are allowed to smile even though they have breast cancer. I plan on taking my time that I do have and doing the most with it. And I just want my girls to know that when they are delivered hard situations, there can be good turned into that. You know, people may see me as dying from metastatic breast cancer, but I see myself as trying very, very hard to live with metastatic breast cancer.
Yeah, so now that you've seen an example of a patient's story, and you know, you've heard from her a real lived experience, I want to talk to you a little bit now about crafting your story. So I really love this slide because we all have a story to share. You know, you have to remember, there is no right or wrong way to share your own personal experience. You just have to be authentic. You just have to speak from the heart. And like Michelle had just mentioned, you just have to be human. And a good reminder is, you know, you don't have to know all the answers. A lot of times I work with advocates and they'll be late, they'll stay up late the night before, they'll be reading through the bill language, trying to make sure they know all the facts, they know everything. And I have to tell you, you know, that's, first of all, that's my job, you know, like I'm the one that will provide the clarity to lawmakers about any of the language and the facts. All you need to do is just share your why, and that, and why that issue is important to you, and then just make a clear ask. So I have another example. We'll watch a short video from Kara. So knowing what you know now, while you listen to her video, try to listen to, you know, what is her hook? What is she saying to draw the audience in? What is her line or her personal connection to this work? And what is her sinker? What is her ask to legislators? You know, and how do you think her story is going to impact change?
My name's Kara, and I'm a breast cancer survivor. A really scary time, and single mom of two kids, so extra scary. I was fortunate to receive excellent care. Much of my care was covered by health insurance. And that's been difficult because that diagnostic screening, especially MRIs, hasn't been covered by my health insurance. And so every year it's a financial undertaking and burden for me to cover that. And I spent about $2,300 this year to cover that MRI and the portions of the 3D mammogram that weren't covered. And I think every year, gosh, that could help pay my kids' tuition. And that is, you know, imagine that is compounded year after year. That would cover my kids' college eventually. And so those are the decisions that I have to make, and every other survivor in this issue, you know, facing these issues, has to make every year. And even with the weight of science and the weight of my oncology team asking for this because they think it's best, and I still have not been able to have those diagnostic MRIs covered by my provider. I think covering for diagnostic imaging, especially MRIs, and for those of us who are really high risk, is going to pay off financially for everyone.
So just to wrap up, because I know we are running a little bit behind on time, I just wanted to also show you where you can sign up to share your own story. And also you can speak with Allison in the back of the room. Wave, Allison, great. She's with our grassroots advocacy team. You can speak to her too about signing up to share your own story. If you follow this link, it will take you to a website. You can fill out your information and then someone from our grassroots team will get back to you. I'm sorry. And if you didn't get the link, I'm happy to share it with you at the end of this, or I think it's also in, on page 12 of your booklets as well. So we're here all day if you need anything. You can also sign up to be an advocacy insider. Here's another link. And this is just for you to stay informed on our monthly newsletters, what we're doing in the Capitol. You can sign up for our action alerts, and it just gives you exclusive access to our Komen-led events. And also, I don't want to forget to make a plug for our social media. You can follow us on social. We are on Twitter at Komen Advocacy, or on Facebook and Instagram at Susan G. Komen Advocacy. You can post photos from today. You can tag us. So just remember those links. And that's it. If you have any questions, I'm here to answer them. And you know, it's like I said, it's, you know, it really, the work that I do really is, it's really for you. Like, I'm inspired every day by folks like yourself who are really the ones on the ground making the change. So I just wanted to say thank you for having me today, and I hope you all got something out of this. All right, thank you.